Oh yeah, baby, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, morning motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again to give God all glory, all honor, all praise. But this right here is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, baby. Let's get into this word. See what the word say, y'all. It is morning time. Oh yeah. Morning time, Sister Regina. I see you. Brother Terrence, I see you. Good morning to you. Alright, y'all see it. It's in the word. Brother John, hey man, you on the street, Brother John, I see you. It's morning time, y'all. It is morning time. Brother Mike. Cousin Keith, what's up, baby? It's morning time. Sister Allison, thank you for hitting that share button. I see you, Sister Lucy. Brother Emery, thank you for hitting that share button. Sister Pam, good morning to you. Y'all see it, man. It's in the word, man. I ain't making it up right there. Romans 8 and 28. Sister Natasha, good morning to you. Deacon Doc, Brother Hoy, good morning to you. It's morning time, y'all. It is morning time. Deacon his mama, good morning to you. Sister Jessica, good morning to you. Listen. It is morning time, man. Welcome to the celebration. Morning motivation. I am Deacon Ford. Once again, we are the morning motivational family. I just want to give a big hug to y'all this morning, man. Big hug to y'all this morning. God has blessed us, allowed us to see another day. Blessed us with the breath of life. And with this breath right here, we celebrating him. We giving him all glory, honor, and praise. This morning, y'all, we in Romans chapter 8. Verse 28, Romans chapter 8, verse 28. Shout out to y'all who are still logging on. Shout out to those over there on YouTube and Instagram. My niece Daisy, my cousin Big John Russ. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Good morning to you, Nikki. I see you on here. Good morning to you, Erica, Keyshawn. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all, man. God is great. I tell you, man, not an understatement. Not an understatement whatsoever. God is truly great and he is worthy to be praised. This morning, y'all, once again, Romans chapter 8, verse 28. Shout out to Deacon and Mother Robinson, Sister Cheyenne, those who continually view. Shout out to those who are in the views who don't even say nothing, who watching. I see y'all watching, man. I appreciate you. I appreciate each and every single one of y'all who watch, and I would appreciate it more if you would grab your word. Make sure you're building that relationship with him. Because that's what it's all about. Your personal relationship with him. So I thank you for watching. But make sure you're grabbing your word and you're reading your word. Romans 8 and 28. Let us pray. God, our Father, as we come to you this morning, in the mighty name of your Son, Christ Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for you being who you are, that you change not, that you are the Son, that you created the sun, the moon, and the stars. And you created us from the dust of the ground, and that you breathed in us the breath of life. And because of that, we are here this morning. And we want to praise you, we want to give you glory, and we want to lift your name on high. Our prayer request this morning is that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, and that your Holy Spirit will guide us into all truth and revelation. We thank you and we love you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Romans 8 and 28. The word reads, "For we know that all things work together for the good of those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose." Verse 29. "For whom he foreknew, he predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he predestined, he also called. Whom he called, he justified. Whom he justified, he also glorified." May God add a blessing to the reader and the hearer, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. It says, "And we know that all things work together for the good of those who love God and those who are called according to his purpose." Boy, hey, bro, Emery, you got to know that. I like, man, listen, that's one thing it says, "For we know that all things." So that's something that you got to know. You got to be confident down in your spirit, man. You got to understand that whatever I'm going through, it didn't say just some things. It didn't say the good things. It says all things, the good and the bad. While we're going through it, we don't really understand that how this is going to play out and how this is actually going to be a benefit, or it's going to work together for the good for us. We can't see that because we thick. We right in the thick, in the middle of it. But the word says that, for we know when I'm confident, when I'm grounded, when I'm rooted, I can understand that all of these things that I'm going through, no matter what it may be, in some form or fashion, it's going to work out for the good. As long as I am moving according to the purpose of God that He has designed for my life. For we know, huh? Can I stand on that? Can I walk through the valley of the shadow of death and be confident, knowing that even though I'm in this shadow, even though I'm walking through the valley, even though all this chaos is going on, I know that at the end of the day, even these things are going to work together for the good, man. Come on, somebody. For real. I need you to think back on a situation. You could think back on a situation. You're like, man, I don't know how I came out of that, or what good was going to come out of that. Maybe it was just the fact that you went through it and you had to learn a lesson. Huh? A lot of times we just got to go through some stuff to learn a lesson and know what not to do next time. The Bible tells us there's nothing new under the sun. So 9 times out of 10, I might have to go down this same road again. I might have to go around the same road again. And the lessons that I learned on this journey, as long as I internalize them and I apply them to my life, then when it comes to come down that time again, I won't go. You feel what I'm saying? I'm not going to go because I'm not going to go there. I learned the lesson from last time. So even a bad situation becomes a lesson and working together for the good, because now as my life continues, I won't make that same mistake. I think it was Meek Mill. Meek Mill said, no losses, just lessons, man. No losses, just lessons. So even in a bad situation, I know it's going to work together. And it goes on in verses 29 and 30, where it says, for he foreknew. The Bible tells us that even while we were yet in our mother's womb, God knew us. He already knew us. He knows the hairs that are on our head. He knows us. He already knew these things, right? And if he already foreknew it, it says he foreknew us, he predestined us that we could be conformed to the image of his son. Once again, walking in that purpose, or called according to his purpose, walking in the footsteps of Jesus. And it says that he predestined, he called us, he justified us, and he's going to glorify us, man. And you're going to be able to walk in your glory, bro. Yeah. Yeah. I see you on here this morning, H2. I see you, Hector. I see you on here, Doobie. Yeah, I see you on here, Dupree. Yeah, we're going to walk in his image according to his purpose. Glorification. Raise us up, bro. Sis, I'm telling you, you may be going through it right now, but remember, it's working out. Ooh, I hear you, Nikki. Nikki say, lesson learned. Huh? Lesson learned. Lesson learned. Correct. Lesson learned. It's going to work together. Just learn the lesson out of it, man. So that when it comes back around, you know that you know what to do and you know what not to do, man. Listen. That's Romans 8, 28 through 30. Romans 8, 28 through 30. I need you to read your word, man. Jump into the comment box and say, I read my word. Remember, it's a wrap for the foolishness, reflection, accountability, preparation. We're getting into our purpose and fulfilling our destiny. I love y'all. God bless you. Signing off, man. It's morning time. Faith over fear. God over everything. Together we made love great again. Love has never lost its power. It just lost its popularity. I love y'all. What's up, sis? I see you on here. Janisha, good morning to you. Remember, y'all, lesson learned. All things work together. Love y'all. God bless you.